We heard this gossip that he left for Nepal, otherwise he was going to be arrested.
Yeah, that we came to know later, because I don't know for what he was going to arrest it, but I think the same thing that how come he paid in US dollars, from where the money came for the fine. Something like that, that they had made some case against him and they were going to arrest him. No, no, not this. This was solved anyway when I wrote down. Yeah, this was that somebody had filed the case against him that he has hurt his religious feelings in some of the books. And you know, in India it's great, people can make cases out of nothing. So the case came and the people came to arrest him. The day when we left, I think the same evening they came to arrest him. That's why I say he always knew intuitively. And in Nepal airline he had their food also, and all the air hostess, two of them, they got his signature in their auto book. And we reached Nepal. There Arun, one of the Nepali sannyasins who had been long-term sannyasins and who had been running the center and ashram there, he had brought all the people there to welcome him at the airport, and he was given a procession and welcome like a king is given. The whole lines of music and dance and how the king's procession goes, he did that. It was very beautiful welcome. And we went to Salty Oberoi, and there again I think we stayed. Do you remember how long?
Yeah, a month maybe?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe more than a month, because we reached there around 6th of January and we left after the middle of February.